two types. One is the chondritis, another one is the osteitis. See, I already said it. For chondritis means the endoskeleton is in a cartilaginous type. For osteitis, the endoskeleton is the bony type. Here, chondritis type of organisms, they are mostly marine nature. This osteitis, it can be live in freshwater habitat and also marine type of habitat. Mostly it can be lives in anywhere. And the very important one, caudal fins. For chondritis type of organisms, the caudal fins are heterocercal, unequal ones. Heterocercal. And if you observe osteichthyes, the caudal fins are two types. One is homocercal, another one is the diphycercal. Homocercal means the caudal fins, I can write here, the caudal fins externally equal manner, internally unequal manner, that type of caudal fins is called as a homocercal. It can be seen in the teleost fishes. Diphycercal means internally and externally equal caudal fins are present, that is called as a diphycercal. The best example is the lung fishes. It means they having a, basically here the respiration is takes place in the gills, but in lung space they having a sacs are present, through that sacs respiration is takes place, that's why that is called as a lung fishes. And then this is the main differentiation. And another one, air bladder is absent. If you observe osteichthyes, air bladder is present. That's why when you have to went to the fish market, at the time of cutting of fish, some white tube like structures, it may be comes outside. That is, we indicates the air bladder. What is use of the air bladder means? Air bladder can use, it is in a hydrostatic organ, it can give buoyancy. It means, neeti meeda tele gunamu kaladi nartham. If you observe the osteichthyes, they having a air bladder is present. That's why bony fishes, normally it can float on the water. But here chondritis, that is a cartilaginous fishes, they not able to float on the water. Always it can swim on the water. But it can take rest on the water sometime. But this type of facility is absent in the chondritis due to the absence of the air bladder. That is the differentiation. And then, if you observe in chondritis type of organisms, the scales are placoid scales. Like this type of scales are called as a placoid scales. And if you observe the osteichthyes, the type of scales are the cycloid scales, thinoid type of scales. This is cycloid type of scales, and this one is the thinoid type of scales. This type of scales are present. And then if you observe respiration, the respiration is takes place through gills. Here 5 to 7 lamelliform gills are present. Here the gills are filamentous form, like this type of, this is the filamentous form, this is the lamella form type of gills are present. And then here excretory material, these are ureotics. Ureotics means the excretory material is the urea. For us also mammals, the excretory material is the urea. That type of organisms is called as a uricotelisms. And then for bony fishes, they are the ammonotelism. The excretory material is the ammonia. Ammonia is the highly toxic nature compared to the urea. And then it is very important character is present regarding to the chondrichthyes. The two mainly seen in the males. Here in the males,